Good afternoon. Sorry for coming in between your tea. And I'll try to talk about this topic, which interests all of us. But the funny thing is, I don't usually use the word spirituality in my writings at all. I never do. I don't feel the need for it. Because jo Sanatan Dharma hai, in Indian thought, there is no separation of the material and the spiritual. Usme kuch fark hi nahi hai. It's exactly the same thing. You cannot understand the divine unless you understand Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth. Unless you understand Lakshmi, nothing moves forward. Everything else comes later. And you cannot say that the goddess Lakshmi is not spiritual, or conversations on Lakshmi is not spiritual, because conversations on Lakshmi is what we call economics. So in India, the concept revolves around three goddesses: Lakshmi, Durga, Saraswati. The study of Lakshmi is economics. The study of Durga is politics. The study of Saraswati is philosophy. No good governance can take place unless you have a very strong understanding of economics, politics, and philosophy. In fact, if you find a bad leader, he has an inadequate understanding of either economics or politics or philosophy. And this is the easiest way to figure out whether a person in your team has leadership capability or not. So let's try to understand this at a very fundamental level. Let's go to basics. When you read many of the Jain Agamas or the Hindu Puranas, there is an obsession with evolution and creation. And the fundamental question that they ask is, what is the difference between a living thing and a non-living thing? जो सजीव है और जो अजीव है, समथिंग विच इज अलाइव एंड समथिंग विच इज डेड, वॉट इज द फंडामेंटल डिफरेंस? एंड द आंसर दैट दे इमर्ज, दे से, इज दैट द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, जो जीव है, इट इज हंग्री, इट सीक्स फूड. द नॉन लिविंग थिंग डज नॉट सीक फूड. So, जो पंच महाभूत होते हैं, the elements, water, fire, wind, they are not alive, they are not hungry, they don't go running after food. But the moment you see living things, the moment you see plants, the moment you see animals, जिसे चराचर कहते हैं, the world of botany, the world of zoology, that's the world of hunger. And the whole purpose of a living organism is it is seeking food. So a plant, why does a plant grow? A plant grows not because it has to grow, but it needs to grow. Because it is growing towards food. It is going towards sunlight. It is going towards water. It's producing branches and leaves and roots because it is seeking food. वो अन्न के पीछे भाग रहा है. इट्स जस्ट द फूड इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम योर फूड. इट इज गोइंग टुवर्ड्स सनलाइट, इट इज गोइंग टुवर्ड्स वाटर, इट इज गोइंग टुवर्ड्स न्यूट्रिएंट्स. व्हेन यू लुक एट एन एनिमल, वेयर इज इट गोइंग? इट गोज अगेन टुवर्ड्स फूड. द हर्बीवोरस एनिमल गोज टुवर्ड्स पास्चर्स. द कार्निवोरस एनिमल इज कंटिन्यूअसली हंटिंग फॉर प्रे. So all of life is this yearning for food that sustains it and keeps it alive. Which means every living thing, unlike a non-living thing, has a target. Hindi mein target ko laksh kehte hain. Laksh se Lakshmi. That which sustains life. That which keeps me alive. Take away Lakshmi and all the plants, all the animals will die. If an animal doesn't go after its Lakshmi, whatever is its understanding of Lakshmi, it will go after it. तो एक भूख होती है. There's hunger. और भूख के लिए इट गोज एंड कंज्यूम्स फूड एंड द एक्ट ऑफ ईटिंग इज वेरी वायलेंट बिकॉज व्हेन द प्लांट ईट्स द सनलाइट इट इज कंज्यूमिंग ए जूल ऑफ एनर्जी इट इज कंज्यूमिंग इट डिस्ट्रॉइंग इट एंड ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग इट इट इज टेकिंग अ मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ विटामिन्स इट्स ईटिंग इनऑर्गेनिक थिंग्स बट एनिमल्स ईट ऑर्गेनिक थिंग्स So the plants are being consumed. The process of eating and consumption is violent. So, jab bhook hoti hai, when there's hunger, there is yearning for food. Bhog chahiye. Lekin bhog chahiye to bali dena padta hai. Something has to die. In the Mahabharata, Yudhishthira is given a forest, Khandav. And Krishna says, what do you want to do with the forest? He says, I want to build a great city, Indraprastha. So Krishna says, फिर जंगल जला दो, जितने भी पशु पक्षी हैं सबको मार डालो. And Yudhishthira says, how can I do this? And Krishna says, फिर इंद्रप्रस्थ की सपन मत देखो. If you want to build a city, you have to clear the forest. Question is, how many forests are you willing to clear? When does your hunger stop? That's a different conversation. But the conversation is, if you want to eat, bali to dena hi padega. Aur agar bali doge, to uska karm bhi bhugatna padega. There is a consequence to your action. There is no escape from consequence. So Yudhishthira says, no, I want Indraprastha. तो जंगल जलाया जाता है और वहां के जितने नाग होते हैं दे लूज देयर होम एंड व्हाट डू द स्नेक्स डू बिकॉज दे लॉस्ट देयर होम द किंगडम हैज बीन डिस्ट्रॉयड दे कम बैक टू स्ट्राइक द चिल्ड्रन एंड द ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन ऑफ द पांडवास ऑल द स्नेक्स कीप अटैकिंग द पांडवास एंड दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट्स गोइंग ऑन व्हाई आर द नागास सो हॉस्टाइल टुवर्ड्स अस And the poet Vyas tells them, warns them, कि देखो तुम्हारे जो परदादा थे सपने देखे थे कि इंद्रप्रस्थ बनाना है खांडव प्रस्थ को तो जलाना पड़ा अगर सपने नहीं देखते तो जंगल में रह सकते थे आराम से ऋषि के जैसे लेकिन राजा बनना था राजा का भोग लेना है तो बलि देना पड़ता है बलि देना है तो कर्म तो भुगतना पड़ेगा देर इज नो एस्केपिंग फ्रॉम कर्म And the children say, but we didn't do anything. No, we didn't hurt the snakes. We are just living in this palace. We are innocent. And Krishna says, no. You are the beneficiary of the bhog. So you have to suffer the collateral damage. There is no escape. There is no free lunch. Bhog chahiye to karm to lena padega. There is no escape. बीज बोगे तो फल निकलेगा मे बी नॉट ऑफ आपको लगेगा कि मीठा फल आएगा जहरीला भी आ सकता है इसलिए कृष्णा इज वेरी क्लियर फल की चिंता मत करो बिकॉज यू हैव नो क्लू व्हाट दैट फल विल बी एंड द कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ इट सो प्लांट्स एनिमल्स ऑल ऑफ देम हंग्री कॉन्स्टेंटली हंग्री फॉर फूड 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 लक्ष्मी 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 चाहिए बट इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ कंज्यूमिंग फूड समथिंग एल्स हैपन्स तो भूख के साथ प्रकृति में एक अनदर इमोशन स्टार्ट्स टू अपीयर भय फियर द प्लांट्स आर ईटिंग इनऑर्गेनिक थिंग्स डोंट माइंड बीइंग कंज्यूम्ड But when animals consume the plants, they're consuming organic things. Living things don't like to be consumed. They resist. वो resist करते हैं कि नहीं 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 आप मुझे consume मुझे मत खाना किसी और को खाना मुझे मत खाना. So every plant starts to produce thorns. Why do plants produce thorns? Because they don't want to be consumed. They produce bitter substances. Because they don't want to be consumed. They are alive. They are begging you not to eat them. Don't eat me. Let me live. but we hack them and cut them and grind them and steam them and roast them and make our vada sambars. Jab bhog karoge to bali chadhega. Hinsa hogi. Chara ya achara. Animal or plant. But somebody is dying. So the plant is terrified, asurakshit hai, it wants to survive, it can't run away, it doesn't have feet. So it produces thorns and tries very hard not to die. Animals, it's easier, they run. They don't want to be caught. Asurakshit hai, bhaybheet hai. Bhay hai ki somebody will eat me, I'll be consumed. And it wants to protect itself. So it grows various strategies to protect itself. In management, it is called de-risking strategies. So every organization functions like an animal. It is hungry. If it has to grow, it needs Lakshmi. But as it keeps growing, it gets increasingly insecure. Because a bigger predator will try to eat it. And therefore you have to protect yourself. And therefore the entire approach is, how do I protect myself? So bhook aur bhay prakriti mein hai. Company ke andar hai. Ghar ke andar hai. Sab jagah hai. Bhook aur bhay. And in order to protect myself, what do? I start creating fences around the house. Or I build castles and citadels. Hindi mein usko hum gad kahenge. Kila kahenge. Ya durg kahenge. Durg se durga. To Lakshmi takes care of bhook. Durga takes care of bhay. Two primary things. So whenever you go to a temple, you will see the gods doing only two things. एक हाथ नीचे होता है, इसे वराद मुद्रा कहते हैं. मैं खाना दूंगा लक्ष्मी, मैं तुम्हें प्रोटेक्ट करूंगा दुर्गा. अभय मुद्रा, यही दो मुद्राएं होती हैं. सो वो हो गया आपका दो, एक इकोनॉमिक्स, एक पॉलिटिक्स. दैट इज द पर्पस ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स, टू क्रिएट अ सिक्योर एनवायरमेंट वेयर पीपल कैन थ्राइव. That's the definition of the role of a king according to Chanakya. Ki bhaiya, aap ek aise surakshit sthan banaye jahan pe Lakshmi ki utpann ho sakti hai. To create an ecosystem of security where wealth comes. When people are getting married, we tell them peace and prosperity. What is peace and prosperity? Peace is Durga. Security, prosperity is Lakshmi. Yehi do cheez chahiye zindagi mein. But why do things get complicated? Why does life become so tough? Look at animals. In order to secure food and to ensure their survival, they have many strategies. They become territorial. Janwar territory mark karte hai. They form pecking orders. There's an alpha, beta, gamma. All this is done to secure their food source. And then humans come along. Humans, manushya. Manushya pashu hai. Sirf ek cheez usme hai jo pashu mein nahi hai. Uske paas man hai. Mind. And therefore in India, to remind us of it, they keep putting tikas over here. कि भैया इधर इधर ही है, ये है सोर्स सबका. हम उसको ऐसे बहुत ब्यूटीफुल ब्यूटीफुल करते रहते हैं, लेकिन बेसिकली वही दिखाने के लिए, भैया तेरा प्रॉब्लम भी इधर है, सोल्यूशन भी इधर है. बिकॉज व्हाट इज मन? मन इज जस्ट मींस इमेजिनेशन. एनिमल्स कांट इमेजिन, एटलीस्ट नॉट इन द ह्यूमन स्केल. दे कैन, ज़ूलॉजिस्ट विल टेल यू एनिमल्स डू इमेजिन, नथिंग ऑन द ह्यूमन स्केल. Now, what are the consequences of imagination? The consequence of imagination is this. Hunger. Let's begin with hunger. animal eats food, its hunger stops. But when we are hungry and imagination comes into the picture, I think of tomorrow's hunger, day after tomorrow's hunger, hunger 10 years from today, hunger for my children, hunger for my children's children. तो भूख अगर इतनी है तो भोग भी बहुत चाहिए ना, तो बलि भी बहुत चढ़ेगा. भूख तो मिटती नहीं है ना. इट्स गुड टू हैव एम्बिशन एज दे से, ड्रीम बिग और बलि करो, करना तो पड़ेगा ना, नहीं तो अदरवाइज हाउ विल यू बी सक्सेसफुल. फॉर्च्यून 500 कंसिडर्स यू वैल्यूएबल ओनली व्हेन यू हैव मोर मनी. तो लक्ष्मी की चिंता तो नहीं छोड़ सकते. If I didn't think of tomorrow's hunger, why would I need an insurance department? So I invest and I invest and I invest. No amount is enough. Now what happens to insecurity? Bhook. Toh ho gaya bhai. A deer gets scared when it sees a tiger, smells a tiger, hears a tiger. We can imagine a tiger all the time. So we are more insecure than any other animal in the world. So how much money is ever enough? It is never enough. Because there is this deep sense ki kal khatam ho jayega. Hota hai na, suddenly money loses value. We can tell our grandchildren, ek din paisa tha, agle din paper ban gaya. That horror of it is got embedded. Wo sanskar ban gaye hamare. It is exactly what our ancestors used to face. Ki ek saal barsaat aati hai, agli saal barsaat nahi aati hai. To ab karte kya ho? Achar banao. What is achar? Storage. Keep storing, keep storing, keep storing, keep storing. Why? Because just in case, 3 saal akal hua to, 4 साल हुआ तो, 10 साल हुआ तो, पुराणों में तो हमेशा 12 साल के अकाल ही आते हैं. सो द फियर ऑफ स्कैर्सिटी कंज्यूम्स यू, यू आर टेरिफाइड. सो इन्फिनिट हंगर एंड इन्फिनिट इनसिक्योरिटी, भूख और भय विच राइजेस टू द पावर ऑफ इन्फिनिटी, दैट्स ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. और अब जितना भी बोलो, fear won't go away. Because human imagination is like water. You can't control it. It flows. Sanskrit mein the word for fluid is saras. Isliye Saraswati, the goddess of imagination. Because unless you imagine, you can't invent or create structures. You can't understand the world. Imagination is the primary tool for knowledge. Imagination is scary because it just frightens the hell out of you, makes you so hungry, so hungry, so hungry. So what do? Your imagination starts working very hard. It invents things to secure yourself, invents things to create more resources. You keep inventing, you keep inventing, you keep inventing. But then Saraswati plays a very clever trick on you. You see, when a bird looks into, or a bird or an animal looks into the mirror, it asks only 4 questions. Is that a predator? Will it eat me? Is that a prey? Can I eat it? Is that a rival? Will it steal my food? Is it a mate? Can we make babies together? If none of the above, the bird doesn't care. It looks at the mirror and forgets about it. It's not interested. But what happens when humans look at the mirror? Do we see ourselves or do we see our imagination of ourselves? I think I am diamond. And then I go to my office to meet my boss on appraisal day. And in my self-assessment, I say I'm diamond. And he looks at it and chuckles. And says, ye bonus nahi milega. You are plastic. You'll get plastic bonus. So I go home very depressed. I meet my wife and I tell her, you know, sorry, darling, not this time. did not get diamond bonus, got plastic bonus, iPhone 7 नहीं खरीद पाएंगे, Samsung से काम चलाना पड़ेगा, so what if it explodes? And the wife says, yeah. And then you ask your wife, what do you really think? Am I diamond or plastic? And she says, and that's a dangerous thing to do, right? And the wife looks at you and says, well, you're not diamond, but you're not plastic. You are cheap plastic. Now your self-worth, self-esteem, everything has gone for a toss. But think about it. Diamond was your imagination. Plastic was your boss's imagination. Cheap plastic is your wife's imagination. That's the power of imagination. We are continuously wondering. Imagination. See, animals have no doubt about who they are. They have no doubt. Usko pata hai ki main hiran hu aur wo sher hai. He doesn't go and tells in front of the sher, pata nahi, shayad wo bhi hiran hoga. Because if you do that, you are dead. But humans have imagination, which means this is wiped clean. So when I meet a stranger, I look at him, and my first thing my mind says, ki aukaat kya hai? So I check, uska pen kaun sa hai? Mont Blanc nahi hai. Kaun si gaadi mein baithta hai? And suddenly I start creating a pecking order through imagination. Ye aukaat shabd, bahut hi powerful shabd hai na Delhi mein. Aapki address kya hai? Aapki gaadi kya hai? Aapki designation kya hai? Bombay mein bhi hai, everywhere, anywhere in the world you go. Where is your address? What car do you drive? Flight kaun sa liya? Kaun si class mein baithe ho? Seat number kaun sa hai? Left mein kaun baitha hai? Right mein kaun baitha hai? These are surrogate markers of who you are. Tumhari aukaat kya hai? Of course, shastron mein aukaat shabd nahi hai. Wahan pe ek dusra shabd hai. Arth kya hai? Tumhara arth kya hai? What is your meaning? Tum ho kaun? And that is a very disturbing idea because we really don't know who we are. Buddha actually went to the extent of saying shunya. Nothing. Sab nashwar hai. Doesn't matter. You don't matter. You don't matter at all. The Buddhist ideology was you just don't matter. There's no such thing as a self. Anatma. Anikka. Nothing matters. Everything is changing. You don't matter at all. And that's very disturbing. Because Buddha is telling you, you don't matter. And you are like, no, I matter. It makes you more insecure. And your insecurity just goes crazy. And you start creating, because you see, jo aapki identity hai, wo nirgun hai. Wo dikhai nahi deta. Mujhe dikhai nahi deta aapka identity kya hai. मुझे सगुण चीजें दिखाई देती है. आई कैन सी थिंग्स दैट आई कैन मेजर. सो मैनेजमेंट टुडे इज ऑल अबाउट सगुण, दैट विच कैन बी मेजर्ड. व्हाट आई कांट मेजर योर इमेजिनेशन. आई कांट मेजर योर अजम्पशन ऑफ हु यू आर. एंड वी ऑल नो द पावर ऑफ अजम्पशंस, राइट? बिजनेस प्लान्स आर बेस्ड ऑन अजम्पशंस. आई हैव एन अजम्पशन ऑफ हु आई एम. You have an assumption of who you are. And when we meet, I can't see your assumption. You can't see my assumption. So what do I see? I look for surrogate markers. I need to feel secure. I need that Fortune 500 list in which my name should be on the top. Phir matlab hai ki meri koi aukaat hai. But in 2017, am I on top? 2018, I'm second. 2019, I'm third. Insecurity. Tum alpha nahi rahe. You are not on top of the food chain. You are not on top of the food pyramid. To tumhari aukaat kya hai? And then that horror sinks in that you don't matter. And that's horrifying. Because no plant matters. Mangoes are wonderful, but one day the mango tree will die. that bird is beautiful, but one day the bird is going to die. You may be a great poet, singer, politician, businessman, artist, sportsperson, but in the end, you will die. You don't matter. And that realization is the most scary, the mortality. Mujhe anant tak rehna hai. I want to be immortal. I will die, but all the things I possess will outlive me. And therefore I hoard and I hoard and I hoard and I hoard and I build monuments that outlive me. Like the pyramids. It still outlives the people who built it. But the people are not there to enjoy it. In India, traditionally, you don't build monuments. In a traditional Vedic concept, you burn the body, you take the ashes and throw it in the river. Or aap jab pitron ko bulate ho, when the ancestors are called, they are fed in this way. We respect you, but ghar ke andar mat aana. You are, isko itihas kehte hai. It doesn't matter. Jada importance mat do, wo chala gaya. Yahan pe itihas nahi, sanatan is more important. That which is forever valuable. What is forever valuable? Lakshmi is forever valuable when you are hungry. Durga is forever valuable when you are frightened. Saraswati is forever valuable when you are seeking meaning. To artha kya hai? And the scriptures are very simple. They said, manushya mein ek hi kshamata hai. Jitne bhi pashu hain, they can only feed themselves. All animals and birds take care of themselves. They don't expect anyone to help them. No animal will say, I need help, because they're incapable of it. The brain is not wired that way. They have to take care of themselves. If a wing breaks, the bird knows it is going to die. Nobody is going to come to the rescue of a bird who has broken its wing. But when I am taking a morning walk and I have a leg sprain, I just expect people to help me. And if people don't help me, I'll say, kitna cruel samaj hai ye. Because I expect people to help because I know I am capable of helping. Animals have no such expectations. I am capable of helping the other. This is human capability. Main aapko help kar sakta hu, aap mujhe help kar sakte ho. I can take care of you, you can take care of me. Main hu jeeva atma. The other, the word for other in Sanskrit is para. Par atma, jaise pardesh. Pardesh is the other country. Swadesh, pardesh. Jeeva atma, para atma. The other. Aur paratma, paratma, paratma karte karte param atma aata hai. To paramatma ke liye pehle para atma ke taraf dekho, dusre ke taraf dekho. And therefore the fundamental ritual in the Vedas was the yajna. Yajna mein aap devata ko aavahan karte ho, unko bhog chadhate ho. Swaha kehte ho, ye jo mera hai wo aapka hai. और उसके बाद देवता आपको तथास्तु देता है, जो तुम्हें चाहिए मिल जाएगा. सो यू इनवाइट द गॉड, यू फीड हिम, एंड इन एक्सचेंज द देवता फीड्स यू बैक सेइंग तथास्तु. जो प्रसाद होता है, एक्सचेंज होता है. मैंने आपको खिलाया, मैंने आपके भूख और भय को निकाला, आप भी मेरे भूख और भय को निकालो. इसे यज्ञ कहते हैं. जो यज्ञ करता है उसे यजमान कहते हैं. तो यजमान देवताओं को बुलाता, ही गिव्स इन ऑर्डर टू गेट. इन मैनेजमेंट द यजमान इज कॉल्ड एन इन्वेस्टर. देवता इज द इन्वेस्टी, स्वाहा इज द इन्वेस्टमेंट, तथास्तु इज द रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट. इफ यू आर नॉट हैप्पी विथ योर आरओआई, प्रॉब्लम किधर है? देवता में प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, आपके इन्वेस्टमेंट में प्रॉब्लम है. आपने देवता को ठीक से नहीं देखा, आपने ठीक इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं की, स्वाहा गलत हुआ. शिवजी को बेल चढ़ाना पड़ता है, विष्णु को तुलसी चढ़ाना पड़ता है. इट इज कॉल्ड कस्टमाइजेशन. वॉट इज एफिशियंसी? सबको एक ही फूल चढ़ा दो, गेंदू का फूल. एफिशियंस है तो गॉड विल से यू आर एफिशियंट इन इन्वेस्टमेंट, आई एम एफिशियंट इन रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट. यही है साइकिल रिलेशनशिप का, फैमिली का, बिजनेस का. अल्टीमेटली इट इज अबाउट टू पीपल टॉकिंग टू ईच अदर, जीवात्मा परात्मा. आर रिलेशनशिप इज ऑफन व्हेन यू स्टार्ट थिंकिंग फर्स्ट आई शुड गेट देन आई विल गिव, यू आर थिंकिंग लाइक अ देवता. When you say, I will first give and then I will get, then you are thinking like a yajaman. Now you have to decide, as Fiki, who are you? Devata ya yajaman? Do I get, then give? Do I give, then get? Once you understand the yajna, to fir bhog samajh mein aayega, बलि समझ में आएगा, कर्म समझ में आएगा, अर्थ समझ में आएगा, लक्ष्मी दुर्गा सरस्वती सब कुछ समझ में आएगा. एंड यू विल नॉट जस्ट बी स्पिरिचुअल, यू विल ऑल्सो बी फैबुलसली रिच. थैंक यू.
Ji, I am simply enthralled. What I heard on Epic was only a very symptomatic thing of what I heard today. Before we ask the audience to participate, and probably I will request Rajeshri Ji Birla to ask the first question, I will set the ball in motion and put it to the most current subject. You talked of Bali and Khandaprast, and that is reminded me of creative destruction of Professor Schumpeter. Would today's demonetization be a kind of a creative destruction?
You see, we have to look at the whole line. Bhook hai to bhog chahiye, bhog chahiye to bali chahiye. बलि देना आसान है कि जब हम अपना बलि नहीं दे रहे, दूसरों को बलि दे रहे, बहुत आसान है. लेकिन उसके बाद कर्म आता है, दैट इज कॉन्सिक्वेंस. उसको एक्सेप्ट करने की क्षमता भी चाहिए. श्री कृष्ण धर्म स्थापना करते हैं, लास्ट में उनको क्या मिलता है? गांधारी का श्राप कि तुम निर्वंश हो जाओगे. क्या हम श्राप लेने के लिए तैयार हैं? अगर श्राप लेने के लिए तैयार हैं तो जरूर बलि दीजिए और भोग भी एंजॉय कीजिए. ये है सनातन. देयर इज नो, एवरीथिंग हैज अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस. वी डोंट नो व्हाट द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस आर, वी डोंट नो व्हेदर इट्स राइट और रॉन्ग. इट्स अ डिसीजन. वी विल ओनली नो, हिस्टोरियंस विल टेल अस, 5 years फ्रॉम टुडे वी विल नो the consequences of a decision taken today. When we are taking the decision, we always believe it's the perfect decision. Because that's what a yajman does. Ek baar aapne swaha kar diya, aap swaha ko wapas nahi la sakte. Sir, Sita takes a decision to feed the hungry. She doesn't know the hungry man turns out to be Ravan, which is what many women realize after marriage. मंडप में थोड़ी ना पता चलता है. सो डिसीशन तो ले लिया आपने, अभी आगे क्या होगा देखते हैं. रामायण, महाभारत, पुराणों में कई बातें हैं. सो वी हैव टू सी कि वी रियली कांट जज इट टुडे. वी कांट, वी हैव टू वेट एंड वॉच वेदर द बलि का फल क्या होगा और कर्म क्या होगा, और वो कर्म में अमृत निकलेगा या विष निकलेगा, और कौन उस विष को पिएगा. क्या उसे भी हम आउटसोर्स करेंगे या खुद पीने की वो क्षमता है? सो दैट इज कॉन्वर्सेशंस दैट वी विल नो मे बी 2-3 years later.
religious and being spiritual.
See, the word religion came into being only in the 19th century. We don't realize this. The word religion really came from colonial powers. It didn't exist. If we were talking in the 17th century, hamare paas koi shabd hi nahi hota English mein religion ke liye. Words would be calm, tumhare kaun. People wouldn't understand iska matlab hi kya hai. But in modern language, when we use the word religion, we mean a set of systems which are very social in nature, which control society. So it has a very social approach. So you can't be privately religious. Religious is always public. Spirituality is very personal. It's private. It is not social at all. It has no other people are not part of it. So samaj ke hisab se agar aap dekhoge, so I can say social spirituality is religion and private religion is spirituality. That's it.
Patnaik ji, how do you compare Arjuna versus Duryodhan or Krishna versus Ram?
You have to give me the parameter of comparison. On what basis do you want me to compare them? For example, all four are men.
But the characters that they play.
Means what? See, it's a very, it's like, you have to give me a basis. So for example, I can classify them as two avatar hai aur two manushya hai. So Ram and Krishna understand the world and have to continuously, helplessly deal with stubborn, stupid people. So Ram and Krishna belong to that category. Who are stubborn and stupid? Arjun will say Duryodhan. Duryodhan will say Arjun. And Ram and Krishna will watch and say, "Theek hai bhaiya, apna classification kar diya." Because everybody thinks other people are stupid and stubborn. So that is one way of dividing it. Arjun, eternally insecure, terrified, focused on target. But the moment he's so focused on target that suddenly one day he gets perspective. He realizes target ke piche ek aadmi hai aur wo aadmi uska bhai hai. He starts thinking about it, he gets so scared he can't take action at all. So it's analysis leading to paralysis. And then you look at Duryodhan. 100 bhai hain. 5 bhaiyon ko khana nahi de sakta. He has a kitchen that can feed 100 people. He can't create a kitchen that feeds 105 people. He feels there is glory in denying those 5 people a source of income. When Krishna says ki 5 gaon de do, ये क्षत्रिय है उन्हें क्षेत्र चाहिए क्षेत्र के बिना वो नहीं जी पाएंगे essentially saying livelihood क्या है should they burn another forest and he says नहीं सुई की नोक I won't share the inability to share so Arjun is a person who is eternally insecure and can only deal with life when he looks at the target but the moment he sees the big picture he gets scared can't handle it Duryodhan is a person who is so obsessed, who hates the other so much that he doesn't even realize the consequence of what he's doing. Neither is fit to be king. Dono rajya ke ayogya hai. Because neither Arjun is thinking of Hastinapur, nor is Duryodhan. Arjun is thinking of Kauravs, Kaurav, and Duryodhan is thinking of Pandavs. But wo rajya hai, jamidari nahi. You are the custodian of a kingdom, but you're not interested in the kingdom. You're interested in your property. Tumne Hastinapur ko jamidari bana di hai. And that is what Krishna is trying to nudge them. Dharmasthapana. Bhaiya, dharmasthapana, ye jagir nahi hai. This fundamental difference, and Ram has to deal with the horror that, haan, ye jagir nahi, ye rajya hai. Main jitna bhi Ram rajya karun, इसी राम राज्य के लोग मेरी पत्नी के बारे में बात करेंगे टैबलॉइड्स में और मुझे अपने पत्नी को भी त्यागना पड़ेगा जितना भी करो राम राज्य को एस्टैब्लिश करने के लिए, मुझे सीता का त्याग करना है, तो आई एम नॉट पर्सनली हैप्पी. सो यू सी इन राम एंड कृष्ण द वल्नरेबिलिटी ऑफ द डिवाइन. दीज आर नॉट पावरफुल गॉड्स, दीज आर गॉड्स हु आर लुकिंग एट ह्यूमन बींग्स एंड सेइंग कितनी क्षमता है तुझ में, बट पास क्यों नहीं होता एग्जाम में. क्षमता है लेकिन इच्छा नहीं है, क्षमता है, संसाधन है लेकिन इच्छा नहीं है. अपने भूख और भय के बारे में सोच रहा है, दूसरों के बारे में नहीं सोच रहा है. राजा कैसे बनेगा?
Devdatji, you talked about a lot of facets here. I want to ask you, you know, in business, we often talk about the issue or feel the issue of, you know, detachment. We don't feel it. We feel very stressed. And you feel, jise aapne kaha na, uska jo result aayega, that may be palatable to you or not. So how do we practice the issue of detachment in a practical way? I'm not saying meditation, bodhi tree ke niche baith jao, but as far as the business context is concerned, and the aspect of karma yogi, ki kaam karte chalo, and don't be overly bothered or don't be flustered. Would you want to talk a little bit about that?
See, words like detachment, which are popular in the spiritual circuit, come from bairagis, come from people who don't have families themselves. Whenever I read a religious scripture, I first check who has written it. And usually it is a celibate man with no family. If it's a celibate man with no family, that means usko duniyadari ke bare mein nahi pata hai. Ramayana Mahabharata is about duniyadari. It's about living in society and dealing with horrific decisions. It's not about walking away gerua vastra pehen ke, jaise aapne kaha bodhi tree ke andar. This is the conflict in India. Ki jo bairagi hai, wo grahasthi ko gyan de raha hai. We should be very careful of such gyan. Detachment hota nahi. अगर आप दुनियादारी में हो तो यू वांट, तुमने काम की, यू कांट गो टू अ फार्मर एंड से अच्छा तुम काम करते रहे, फल की चिंता मत कर, वो दो थप्पड़ देगा, बोलेगा भैया मेरा हार्वेस्ट नहीं होगा तो मैं घर कैसे चलाऊंगा. द फैक्ट इज द ह्यूमन माइंड, नो मैटर सरस्वती राइट इट्स फ्लोइंग, यू कैनॉट स्टॉप द ह्यूमन माइंड फ्रॉम इमेजिनिंग द बेस्ट एंड द वर्स्ट टू ड्रीम. दैट्स वॉट मेक्स अस ह्यूमन. वी आर ह्यूमन बिकॉज आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग अ ग्रेट हार्वेस्ट. I'm also human because I'm afraid when the harvest will come, there will be a tsunami or a tornado and destroy the harvest. Wo dar to hai hi. Empathizing with this and being kind to yourself, that this is what being human is. You become kinder to yourself and to people around you. Rather than telling them don't be attached, allow them to be attached and hold their hand as their heart breaks. And dance with them when it doesn't break, because both possibilities exist. I think that gentle kindness, karuna, that's why the early Buddhism had no concept of karuna. But when the goddess comes, Tara comes into Buddha's life in the Mahayana Buddhism, it becomes more domestic. Aur wo gyan, pragna jisko kehte hain, uske saath karuna aati hai. Ki bhaiya intellectual bahut achhi hai, detach raho, detach raho, detach raho. But perhaps more important quality is karuna. Empathy. In today's society, everybody is very intelligent and everybody is being very right. But the biggest factor which is missing is empathy. You can't do good planning if you don't have empathy. Dil nahi hoga, to aap scenario planning nahi kar sakte. Aapko dusron ka dard dikhai hi nahi dega. Kyunki Arjun ke jaise aap keval target dekh rahe ho. Perspective, target is dhyan, I mean focus is dhyan, dharana is perspective, see the big picture, and you'll suddenly realize in while you are worried about our own attachment and detachment, there are people far more terrified than you, and I think that calms us down, because if I get scared, then what will happen to that person? It's like when you are in a crisis and your child is next to you, you try to hold on strongly because you don't want your child to get more scared, because the child will get more scared if the parent gets scared. So you have to keep, that is empathy. Just expand this to a larger picture. As a businessman, think of all those workers who will lose their job if you don't succeed. Because if you don't succeed, you are going to shut that factory down. You have enough personal wealth to survive. What about them? Because they are daily wage earners. Unki to khatam. So that will make you sort of, it'll add to your anxiety, but it'll also make you more graceful and dignified in dealing with complex matters. I feel, this is my understanding. Yeah, thank you.
My name is Chetan Sharma, sir. I want to know, sir, if I am working, I am thinking for serving the society, means the way you saw, somebody else has created some destruction, I want to correct it. So again, I should be ready for my destruction.
You see, nobody has destroyed society. See, when we make such statements, we are giving ourselves too much importance. Nature is nature, culture is culture. The world is the way it is. This is our savior complex. You know, when you want to be a savior, you continuously believe there are monsters out there. Because savior ki koi avashyakta nahi hoti hai jab tak demand nahi hota. Aur demand kab hota hai? Jab monsters hote hai duniya mein. To nayak banne ke liye khalnayak ki avashyakta hoti hai. To jab aap nayak banna chahte ho to sab jagah khalnayak ki khalnayak dikhai dete hain. But agar nayak nahi banna hai, yajaman banna hai, to duniya mein keval devata dikhai denge. To decide, nayak banna hai ya yajaman banna hai? I would recommend yajaman.
I'm Karanveer Mundre. My question is, I run a biotech firm, and my question is in terms of when we hire people today, we have this feeling, especially of the new hirees who are coming out, that they don't have the set of principles that we had when we were, you know, starting our life or our this thing. Do you feel that the set of principles in terms of loyalty, consistency, have eroded? And if you think they have, why do you think they have eroded, or do you think they have not eroded? And how do we hire better and hire the right kind of people with the kind of commitment that we desire in our companies?
See, this is a classic example of karma, consequence. We are, you see, many of us, I'm assuming, looking at the age group, grew up watching a film called Sholay. Angry young man, very, very angry, very, very angry. That's the story that you saw when you grew up. The kids you're hiring today grew up watching Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. Do you see a difference between their two worlds? Sholay was made during the License Raj. Anger. That time there were smugglers, a word which I don't think young people today understand. Uska matlab kya hai? Sab kuch mil jata hai na aaram se. Amazon.com, Flipkart, mil jata hai, 2 seconds mein mil jayega. Ek zamana tha, then when your relatives came from abroad, you were envious of them. Today you're like, oh, job ke liye aaye ho? Bas hai nahi kuch wahan pe. And then you see a younger generation which grows up with a Karan Johar film where there is no poverty. It is an India that I haven't seen. It's beautiful and plush and wonderful. We were called it aspirational India. So, wo duniya se aaye hain. Ab thodi na aapke values usme honge. So, Amitabh Bachchan Karan Johar se baat kar raha hai. To alag duniya hai na. Bahut hi alag duniya hai. To darshan kijiye, ye devta alag hai. To swaha bhi theek se dijiye.
Previous comment on empathy and attachment, I wanted, so here, if you could throw a bit more light on detached attachment and how do you practice it?
You know, I suspect you'll both read the same book. Don't practice it. It doesn't matter. These are complicated words which are just designed to make simple life complicated, because then you need people like me to explain it. So it's for me a demand generation activity. Life is not that, you know, detached attachment. Chhod do. I think, at least I don't, maybe I don't know the answer. Maybe you'll have to ask some Guruji. I'm not, as he clarified. Because it's not that complicated. Life is not that complicated. And clearly you know the answer. Because it's a multiple choice that I have to select which one, right?
Is there any analogy from the...
Arre, mujhe samajh hi nahi aata hai wo kya hai. Toh main kaise samjhaun?
I have a question. Can you elaborate here?
example about the belief system in Eastern companies and the Western companies, particularly in reference to the NGOs?
Well, it's too large a question, and I don't know how much time we have. We must clarify the word East. East of what and West of what? Because India comes between the East and the West. East is the Oriental culture, the Chinese and the Japanese are the Oriental cultures, which are influenced by Confucianism and Taoism. West is everything which is west of India, where there are two major philosophies at work, or mythologies at work, the Greek mythology and Abrahamic mythologies. Simple difference between the two is, I will use Hindi words, ek paigambar model hota hai aur ek digambar model hota hai. Paigambar paigam leke aata hai. He comes with a message. So the Western model assumes the need for a message or the need for a solution, which means there's a problem and you have to make a solution. The digambar model doesn't function around that model. It says, if the digambar model looks, digambar is the naked ascetic. वो पैगाम लेके नहीं है, वो दुनिया का दर्शन करता है. एंड ही सेज द वर्ल्ड हैज नो बिगिनिंग अनादि, द वर्ल्ड हैज नो एंड अनंत, नथिंग लास्ट फॉर एवर, डेथ इज ऑल्सो टेम्पररी. तो इट सीज लाइफ एज वेव्स, देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम, देर इज नो सोल्यूशन, लाइफ इज गोइंग ऑन. आपको इसके अंदर जाके कुछ अर्थ ढूंढना है, अपने लिए मीनिंग ढूंढना है. सो ऑल आर एक्टिविटीज आर डिजाइन टू गिव आर सेल्व मीनिंग, अर्थपूर्ण जीवन जीने के लिए आप जी रहे हो. और एंड दैट इज द कॉन्वर्सेशन. सो देर टू डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ लुकिंग एट इट. सो हाउ डू यू अप्रोच अ प्रॉब्लम? इफ यू अप्रोच द प्रॉब्लम एज अ जेंटलमैन बिफोर सेड, देयर इज अ प्रॉब्लम एंड आई हैव टू सॉल्व इट, इट्स अ क्लासिकल वेस्टर्न मॉडल विच इज कॉल्ड ऑब्जेक्टिव बेस्ड मैनेजमेंट. इंडियन मॉडल इज वॉट आई वुड कॉल्ड कॉन्सिक्वेंस बेस्ड मैनेजमेंट. नो मैटर वॉट यू डू, गुड और बैड, it has a consequence, good or bad, jo aapko bhugatna hai is zindagi mein, nahi to alag zindagi mein. And that for the, it is non-interventional, it is continuously doing what is natural to you, which you feel gives your life meaning. But never be under, it's like a mango tree saying I have to produce mangoes to save the world. The forest doesn't need the mango tree, the mango tree needs the mangoes. In the same way, our lives are, we are mango trees in a forest. The forest will survive without us. But our life will become meaningful when we produce the mangoes that will be eaten by the other animals. That's a very different model. Yeah?
Just trying to figure out the rationale. Is there a relation between mythology and myth, the two words?
It's mythology is the study of myth.
Right. So when we say Ramayana and Mahabharata are mythologies, they do come from the word myth.
Yeah. What do you mean by myth?
That's what my question is. So when people start believing...
So you're asking a question about a word you have no understanding of.
That's right.
Okay. Just clarifying that.
That is exactly what I'm trying to figure out. Because I normally get confused when people start relating mythology with reality.
Well, mythology is real.
Is it?
You asked the meaning and I'm telling you the answer. But you're not willing to accept the answer because you already know the answer that you're expecting. You see, the thing is, if I give you the Bible and tell you, ye library hai, yahan pe do section hai, fact, non-fiction and non-fiction, where will you keep the Bible?
Probably keep it in fiction.
Okay. That library belongs to St. Xavier's Institute. No, you won't be killed, you'll lose your job. Nobody is that violent. In our imagination, yes. But in reality, because they will say you don't know enough. But if it was a institute which is owned by the Atheist Federation of the world, you would get a promotion. So how do you define a Bible? Because for many people, everything in the Bible is true. For you, it is not true. Who is right? You, the believer is right, or the non-believer?
Believer, because they believe in it.
Yeah. So now let's look at the world very simply. There are some truths that are everybody's truths, like hunger and fear, वो सबके लिए true है. Maybe not for inanimate objects, for animate objects, everybody's truth is a fact. Harry Potter is fantasy, nobody's truth. इन दोनों के बीच में होता है somebody's truth, that is myth. ये मेरा सच है, let me believe it. It is your son coming and saying, I love this girl. And you will say, no, infatuation. Because for you it is fantasy. But for him it is fact. That is the world of mythology. Respecting other people's beliefs. So myth is subjective truth. So we should not divide the world into fact and fiction. That's a very primitive approach to thinking, which is very 19th century. In the modern world, where we are thinking postmodern, post-structural, we have many more models of thinking. Myth stands between fact and fiction. And this is a complex world of nuance. Sabke liye nahi bas ki baat hai. Wo aadmi patthar ki pooja kar raha hai, tumhe takleef kyun? Because tum salesman ho na, tum bechna chahte ho apni product bechna chahte ho. Ye patthar nahi, usko us patthar ki pooja karo. So it comes from this marketing approach that I know what is the truth. Nobody knows. The greatest fantasy in the world is my truth is the truth.
Yeah, Lakshan. Treta and Dwapar also, we had not the perfect situation. So Kalyug hai and Varnashram ka jo dharma hai. Why the political leader or the social system is not accepting? Either we don't believe our scriptures. Ek aisa level पे आ गए हैं कि we don't want to believe. If we believe, then one has to accept it. This differences of society will be there only. How to, I mean, with this kind of a technology invention, everybody say, no, I must also have a point of mice here. How to satisfy the Varnashramdha?
Sir, सब माया है. तो इतना tension मत लीजिए. आपके पहले भी जंगल था, आपके बाद भी जंगल रहेगा. ये सोचना कि हम मैं आने के बाद राम राज्य होगा जो हमेशा रहेगा, ये तो सबसे बड़ी मिथ्या है. बिकॉज हमको लगता है कि हम ही सब दुनिया के सॉल्व, हम केवल आम के पेड़ हैं. ट्राई टू प्रोड्यूस गुड मैंगोज, दैट्स अ गुड जॉब. फुली अवेयर दैट वन डे यू विल नॉट प्रोड्यूस मैंगोज. एंड आई थिंक येस, देर आर मैनी मैनी थिंग्स इन द स्क्रिप्चर्स विच आर वंडरफुल. But if we focus on empathy, and it's a very difficult thing to do, ki dusron ka bhook aur bhay ko dekhna, I think dharma sthapana will happen very, very easily. Yeah? Thank you.
Sir, one last question. Is here, but sir, here. Sir, I'm Anil from Surat. After 8th of November, there was a lot of talk about corruption in India. And some author from New Zealand wrote about, transactional nature of we Indians. You must have also stumbled upon that article. And he said that we, enter into transaction even with the God also, and that has entered into our psyche and DNA over ages. So how do we Indians respond to such type of, interpretation of our things from outside, sir?
Why do you give white people so much importance?
Because they write their articles in Times of India.
Are people entitled to have a point of view? If you don't respect another person's point of view, it's his point of view. इसलिए इसको opinion column खोलते हैं. वो यथार्थ column नहीं होता है, वो opinion column होता है. उसको opinion दीजिए, फिर आप अपना opinion दीजिए. दोनों माया है. तो टेंशन क्या है? वो उसका opinion दे रहे हैं. या ही, this is the way he understands. संवाद कीजिए ना, हमेशा विवादास्पद रूप से. फिर तो हमारे पार्लियामेंट जैसे होगा ना. संवाद नहीं होता है वहां पे. संवाद से ही मंथन होता है, मंथन से ही क्षर सागर से अमृत निकलेगा. आप संवाद नहीं करोगे, मंथन नहीं करोगे, विवाद है. क्योंकि विवाद में हम नायक हैं, और नायक बनने की सोच है तो सब खलनायक है. तो युद्ध करने की इच्छा है, धर्म स्थापना करना है, लेकिन श्राप नहीं लेंगे. So this is the tragedy. Vivad kyun karna hai? Suno na uski baatein. Maybe there is some value in it. What is wrong in transaction? It is okay, no? Problem aapko hai ki transaction word se takleef hoti hai na. Lekin swaha tathastu to transaction hi hai na. Badi baat kya hai? आवाहन कीजिए भगवान का, दीजिए, बट भगवान कौन है उसे सोचिए, किसको भगवान मान रहे हैं? दरिद्र नारायण भी है. तो आई थिंक वी गेट टू एक्साइटेड. इट्स अ ट्रांजेक्शन. व्हाट्स रॉन्ग इन अ ट्रांजेक्शन? आई लव अ ट्रांजेक्शन. आई मेक नोट ऑफ द पॉइंट दैट आई हैव नॉट चार्ज्ड फॉर दिस सेशन. तो फिकी ऋण में है, ब्राह्मण तो दक्षिणा जरूर लेगा.
सर दिल मांगे मोर. क्लोज होने के आगे एक मैं लाइटर वेन में पूछता हूं. आपने कहा अभी ग्रीड एंड फियर, कभी वॉरेन बूफे भी आपसे पढ़े थे?
सी एज अ पर्सन ही इज नीदर हंग्री नॉर अफ्रेड. वो उसकी स्किल है. ही हैज द एबिलिटी टू जेनरेट वेल्थ. ही इज वेरी गुड एट इट. उसका आम वो है, उसको आम बनाने दीजिए ना. हम वो नहीं शायद बन सके. हम अमरूद बनाएंगे. लेकिन ये आत्मज्ञान का मतलब है क्या? मतलब क्या है कि ये जानना कि भैया तुम आम के पेड़ नहीं हो, तुम अमरूद के पेड़ हो. लेकिन जब अमरूद का पेड़ आम का पेड़ बनना चाहता है तभी तो डिप्रेशन होता है. And that's what happens. I think he is doing what he is doing because he's very good at it and he's proved it time and time. It's a skill. He possesses an intuitive ability. It's a skill. Potters make pots. Warren Buffet makes money.